Under the Civil Service Reform Act, the SES was established to ensure that the executive management of the government is responsive to the needs, policies, and goals of the nation, and otherwise is of the highest quality. Senior executives share the opportunity to lead, set policy, and expand the capabilities of their agency. This is a tremendous opportunity and privilege. The members of the SES are leaders of the federal workforce in a budget-constrained environment. Senior executives must be good stewards of taxpayer dollars so citizens receive the best value for their money. Unfortunately, scandals perpetuated by senior executive branch officials have shown that some senior leaders failed to meet the standards expected of federal leaders. This committee has held numerous hearings on the lack of accountability in the SES, and it is essential to restore the public's confidence in the government's executive corps. The Senior Executive Service Accountability Act brings much-needed reform to the senior executive service and gives agencies common-sense tools to hold senior leaders more accountable for their taxpayer-funded work. Specifically, this bill extends the probationary period for individuals appointed to the SES from 1 year to 2 years. It promotes fairness by making senior executives subject to suspensions of less than 2 weeks. This is the same employment standards as the employees they supervise. It establishes that members of the SES receive performance requirements in writing before the start of an appraisal period. It eliminates the current loophole that allows an executive who has been removed for poor performance and placed in a new federal job from retaining their executive salary, which only makes sense. Finally, this bill provides for an expedited removal process for SES due to performance or misconduct. This process for expedited removal was enacted for the Veterans Affairs SES in the Veterans Access Choice and Accountability Act, which passed the House with bipartisan support and was signed into law by the President in August of 2014. And I might note that every member of this committee who was there at that time voted for that act with those provisions in it. A majority of federal workers, including senior executives, are hardworking public servants, as our chairman has expressed several times. We thank them for the hard work. However, as we've seen repeatedly in hearings before our committee, there are bad actors who have abused their position. The Senior Executive Service Accountability Act is an important step towards holding bad actors accountable and restoring public trust. This legislation is very similar to legislation that passed this committee and the House last Congress, and so I urge my colleagues to support this legislation. And I yield back.
Thank the